All right, here today with buddy Ryan Carlson.
Hey,
everybody. If anybody remembers some of my old school battle reports, we had some early games with his, he was playing some Americans. We did a special assault on Brecourt Manor, where I got my butt kicked. And we played something else too, but and Ryan switched jobs and we haven't had a chance to get together, but now we are starting our escalation slow grow campaign, and we're gonna be playing some of that. Now, Ryan did buy Japanese army, but like I said, he wanted to, wasn't able to play much, but he is using the guest army that Alan and I picked up a little while back, and he's going to be playing the Soviets in the slow grow, which this is hopefully going to get him fired up to get those Japanese assembled, which we still need to have. We should have a assemble and a gluing party night.
I'm okay with that.
Just like get a 12 pack and
they're all still in the box, ready to go.
Yeah, we should do that. Get some couple things of super glue, a 12 pack, and some steaks, and throw them on the grill when it gets warmer. Just sit out there and glue. All right. So you want to go over your army list here, Ryan? That way you can make sure you can refresh.
All right, we got one junior lieutenant.
All right, that's this guy right here. And so he's inexperienced.
Yeah. And we got one LMG squad.
That would be this 10-man squad right here.
NCO.
Okay.
Inexperienced, I think. Yep, inexperienced. No, they're regular.
They're regular. So that's your regular squad.
Yep, they got one rifle squad that's inexperienced.
That would be this squad. They're the same size.
And
10 men each.
Free rifle squad is inexperienced.
Right there. And so got 12 men with multiple cocktails. And then what's the theater selector that you chose?
Fanatic.
Yeah, because the theater selector that you're playing is the Battle of Stalingrad.
Yep.
So that means he could make all his infantry fanatic for +3 points, but it allows him to take the inexperienced squad for free with Fanatic. So that's now a very interesting and dangerous unit. Okay, so what's the next thing you got?
We got a medium machine gun that's regular with a gun shield.
Right there. So we're playing the Season 3 rule, so it's 6 shots.
And then we got a sniper team that's regular.
Right here.
And then we got a medium mortar team that's inexperienced.
Right there.
And then a T-60 tank that's regular.
All right, and we don't have a T-60 tank model, so we have a Panzer III with a Panzer II turret to simulate that, and I think it will look just fine. And then I've got, over here, is my French that I've been working on. Now, Adepticon kind of put me behind schedule as far as getting these done like I wanted, but I got a second lieutenant. He's regular, so he's only the +1, and he's got an attendant. Then I have inexperienced infantry section x3. So 1, 2, 3. And all those have a light machine gun and a VB launcher. I'm trying the VB launcher just because I can. And since I'm inexperienced, I figure what the hell, why not? They are expensive at 20 points each. The French Army special rule is that if you take 3 inexperienced squads in a platoon, you get a fourth one for free at the cheapest point level, which is they're all identical. So I have 4 inexperienced squads. They're all 8 men. You can see I've got my British models filling in. British Expeditionary Force is going to be helping the French. And then I have a regular Senegalese squad. Senegalese are regular tough fighters. So they get 2 attacks each in close combat.
Nice.
These guys right here.
Nice.
And, but they're only a small squad of 6. I have an anti-tank rifle. So 36-inch range. It's only got +2 at close range. So as long as you stay more than 18 inches away.
I don't like that.
Then I've got a light mortar team. The light mortar team is regular. Oh, my boy's anti-tank rifle is actually veteran.
Oof.
Yeah, so they need 5s to kill them. I have a light mortar at regular, and then I have my other French Army special rule is that they get a free medium howitzer, so it's got free of charge, and then that's regular. Do you remember the Soviet Union Army special rules?
Not really. I only ever played Soviets.
Yes. Their special rules are actually pretty good. One is that they get the free inexperienced squad, kind of like how I got mine.
Anti-tank rifle, or anti-tank grenades, fanatics.
Yes. So the Army, if they ever die from a break check, like say they take more than 50% casualties, and you have multiple pins and you roll and they would normally die, they get to re-roll.
Nice.
So, it's bullshit. But it is a very good rule. They get the free and experienced squad. And then, what else do they have?
Vodka.
They have vodka, which is probably the re-roll.
Yeah.
Okay. Their special rules are the one I just said, the fail. Infantry artillery models. And then you get the free squad. You can include a commissar purchase, so you may want to think about in the future games. It's a headquarters choice. It's real cheap. If somebody doesn't follow an order, like they fail a morale check, he'll shoot a guy and let you reroll.
I like that.
And then they have what's called mass batteries. Anytime that you would have a preparatory bombardment, you roll the D6 plus 6, and you get to roll a second dice and keep the highest for the range of it. So mainly it's the reroll and the free squad. All right, so we're going to be playing on this board here. Ryan and I kind of went over the terrain already as far as the houses and the roads, double movement for vehicles, and walls and whatnot. So we're gonna roll up a scenario. So I'll let you do the honors.
Number five.
Five is top secret. Oh, that should be fun. That's the one with the plan. Wait, didn't we play that one once?
That was our first one.
Yeah.
It has that car that was broken down.
Yeah. Yeah. And then you try to grab the plans and get them off the board. It's a meat grinder, that's for sure. All right. So it's top secret. First, set up the objective marker on the center of the table. This could be a wrecked light aircraft, perhaps a fallen parachute or something. Both players roll a dice. High score picks the side of the table. No units are set up on the table. Everything's in reserve. So that could affect our inexperienced stuff quite a bit, as far as, because it's minus one trying to come in from that. So I have some crates. I have some barrels. That'd make a good one, probably.
Oh, yeah. It's right in the center. There's going to be a kill box right there.
All right. So everything comes in from reserve. That means you give an order dice to it, has to be a run or an advance, and you have to test to bring everything on. So it's a leadership check minus one.
Okay.
So most of our stuff's gonna be sevens. I'm like, the good news is, you know, none of the artillery's starting on board, so you don't have to worry about that.
Yeah.
You can't come in and fire. So it should be pretty interesting. So you gotta get that thing, get it off the thing. It's six turns with a possible seventh turn on a roll of four, five, or six. We'll just start drawing. Boom. Great, that's you.
Let's pick one?
Yeah. Whatever thing you want to try to bring in. I tend to leave my vehicles last.
Yeah, I'm not bringing
that way you can
we'll
see
use
where
that,
everything's at and pop
that,
it.
That free squad. We'll run those guys out first.
I can pass them over to you.
What side of the board are we starting at?
Yeah, that fanatic group. Anywhere on that board edge.
Hell, you can start them right here and run them right into the damn thing. And it's 6 inches, isn't there? 12?
You can run 12. Yeah. Actually, you have to test.
Oh, yeah.
I totally forgot about that. Hopefully, they curse you. I'll give you some yellow dice for your shooting. Because you're cowardly. And I'll give you some of these big dice for odds and ends, whatever you want.
Alright, is it two dice to roll?
It's two dice. So normally, inexperienced and morale is at 8, so you need a 7 or less to bring them in. Oh yeah, they're good to go. They're excited, man, they're fanatics. That's gonna be actually, if we get into close quarters, combat.
We're gonna run them since we can't really do much.
Okay.
And Where's your Zellbrumen right here? It's like Brizzard run to the hedge.
Yep, sounds good. Alright, so here comes the Fanatical. Perfect deal. Blue, sorry, me. I will cast for a inexperienced squad myself. I have four of them, so I need a seven as well. So I'm good on a three. This is rough ground here, by the way, which means you can't run in it.
No.
It's probably going to be irrelevant, but...
Are you pushing back 6 inches then?
No, just this black one.
Oh, the black one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Those are wheat fields, so they provide, they're like basically tall grass.
Yeah. It
doesn't affect your movement, it doesn't affect line of sight. Vehicles don't get the tall grass, they're too big, but you got hedges along.
Yeah.
And then, nope, they're good.
So like when we come to the board, kind of like say you move like 12, can I put like, say, one of them right here?
For your infantry?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can enter a building on a run order, so you can go to the ground floor. Since that building kind of has a ladder way up the side, you can do Zungi, you get to that within 6 inches, then you can use your other 6 inches to go into the roof.
Okay.
So you can definitely do that. And then
should have asked that earlier. I told you I had to ask you.
That's good. Yeah, that's a good question. And also, like your vehicles, if they enter on the road or something, they get double movement. So you can advance. Normally, track vehicles move 9. You can go up to 18 inches on the road.
That ain't bad at all.
You can only turn once with track on an advance. Can't turn it all on a run. Okay, I'm about to bring the squad in. And I will run my squad as well. Take like machine guns hardly since me and Alan started playing some of the season 3 rules. I was like, really kind of like them a lot.
Where do you get the season? You just download off the website?
Yep, download. It's a WWP. it's an unofficial rules, but it's like the most common unofficial
rules.
So it's like a grandmaster of club rules that. Is really nice, and I'm hopeful that those changes will be incorporated in the second edition when it comes out. The most of them are common sense, just rule glitch type stuff.
Yeah.
A light machine gun shouldn't be 20 points. It gives you basically one extra shot and 6 inches of range, because one guy has to help load it. So we normally pay 20 points for two riflemen. A light machine gun only gives you 3 shots total. So his rifle goes away and his rifle goes away. So again, you gain one shot for 20 points. I could see a 10 point, but 5 points, because people like the historical accuracy is also a very important thing to a lot of people.
Oh, yeah.
There's a reason why worldwide a 10, an 8 to 12 man squad with a light machine gun was the standard issue infantry squad, because the infantry used a light machine gun for the suppression.
Yep.
All right, so I'm in there on a run.
Right. Yeah. Alright. I think we're gonna go with the machine gun.
Okay. So it's a regular, so it's normally a 9, so it'll be an 8.
Got 6.
11. You guys suck.
Damn Russians.
Yes. That's good for me. I don't want that thing setting up shop. Blue. I'll test another inexperienced squad. I'll test my singlees. They're my regulars.
Okay.
So they're normally a 9, so it'll be an 8. So I'll run them. So that's 6. I thought I was gonna copy you. And they'll run. I care about their lives a little bit more, so we'll. I should put that right in the middle. It'd be much more brutal right there.
Okay.
Yeah, let's put it here. That's where it should be.
That's gonna be a giant kill box.
Yeah. That's where it should be. Because this is too much, where there's a building in the way.
Yeah.
That's where it should be.
Man, it's gonna be a murder box.
Right? It's gonna be. It's gonna be get into this stuff and try to suppress for the protection, or just get it and just have bodies all over the street. That's a good spot right there, because then it's like, I gotta come out, or you gotta come through.
And the Russians, they just run right towards, they wouldn't even care.
Right, and I still want these guys there, because I've got plenty. I want them in there, and I want it, and then try to come around with my inexperience. All right, next dice. Me. Fucking 3 for 3.
Sure, his darts aren't loaded.
No, not. All right, run order. Run. See, this is one of those ones where doesn't really, nothing starts on the board. I'm pretty sure that includes snipers and spotters and stuff. So this is one of those weird ones. You're gonna have to like run your spider sniper in. If you have a sniper. I don't have a sniper. I wonder if we should have. I think we probably should have put him on the board. Your sniper. And I don't have a spotter. I don't have anything.
I can put him on the board.
Yeah. Let's use. What you're supposed to do is actually roll the dice and we alternate. Because you can put it anywhere on your side of the board, up to half. It has to be more than 12 inches away from any objective, though. So, we're supposed to do this before we start coming in.
So basically, all that. So don't put them in the building.
Yeah, you can't be there. You could probably be in that one.
Sure. I was right at 12.
So, I guess I'll go with my... I got a lot of squads, don't I?
Yeah.
Seems so, anyway. I'll go with another inexperienced squad. 9 be an 8. I mean, 8 be a 7. Hey. I will run.
I'll have to come out eventually.
Just my light mortar. What did I say that was?
They're great experience. Were they regular?
Light mortar is regular. So it'd be a 9, be an 8. 8. Glad I wanted it regular. And he's gonna come in on an advance order. We're gonna try, because you can move and shoot it. I haven't painted them. Or even prime them, so I'm sure they will die quickly. They have to be able to see what they're shooting at, though. And they only got a 24-inch range. Oh, I can advance 6. I'll come to here. I'll try to plop a mortar at that sniper right up there. 24-inch range. Should be good there. Because he's in the building, so they'll be targeting the top of that building. I need a 6. And it doesn't necessarily hit him. If I happen to roll a 6, then I have to roll to see what floor it detonates on.
Nice.
Yeah, it's not very good against houses like that. So I'm looking for a 6. Woo! So I'll need a 5 next turn. And once I score a hit, then it zeroes in on a 2-up. But then we'll still have to roll to see what floor it detonates on every time. But it gets annoying. Just try, you know, it's like, do you want to move your sniper or do you want to see how lucky I am?
Yeah.
You're going to get to react quite a bit, it looks like. All right, others. Other... Last inexperienced squad. So 7. 8. So they fail. You don't have to bring your stuff neither. You can always go down, but I figured I'd just get on the board. Don't want to be like turn 6 and still have done that. You know, turn 5, you're still got to
Jeez Louise.
I guess my lieutenant, I'll test. He's a regular. So a 9 be an 8. Ooh, close. Trying to get those 6s. Did buy him regular, so that passes. Don't want to be near that sniper anywhere. So I will run. Get him in the game. Alright, let's see what we got. There's some gray.
There's finally something for me. Let's see here. I think I will go with my mortar team.
Okay. They are inexperienced.
Yep, so 7. 4, 5, 6, 7.
Brings them in. Alright, so they can come in, they can run or advance just like infantry. They just can't fire because it's a fixed team. Light mortars.
They gotta see what they're shooting at, don't they?
Yep, they're gonna have to see what they're shooting at, so you're probably gonna wanna be somewhere where you can see the secret plans, because you know that's where people are gonna be coming.
Oh, yeah. I think I will just bring him in already here. I'll put him right there. At least they can see what they're shooting at.
Right on. Alright, setting up shop with the medium mortar. And me again. Since I said that was rough ground, I can't push artillery pieces through rough ground, which actually kind of sucks. So I'll bring it right there.
You put it right there. Just keep it right there in the very corner.
I'm going to bring it in over here. I'm going to try to bring it in right here. It's a regular, so 9 be 8. 7, so good. You got kind of a catty corner from you. Same principle. Now this is a beast right here. It's plus 3 against armor and 2d6 HE. So yours is d6 HE. Six inches. Plus 3 is not that powerful, but against a light tank,
oh, yeah.
I need a 5 to glance because you have an 8 armor. And then, even if I hit, it's a 5 to glance it and a 6 to penetrate it, as long as it's front armor. So
yeah.
It's not like super death or anything, but obviously.
Alright, let's bring in my. We'll bring my regular squad.
Okay.
Rifle squad. Or any, well, I guess they're both inexperienced.
Mm-mm.
Oh, the LMG squad.
Yeah, you've got one that's regular.
I'll bring my LMG squad in.
Alright.
Alright, so I need a 8.
Yep.
4.
Ah, son of a bitch. Uh-oh, it's gonna be up to the fanatics.
Yeah, this has plagued me, that damn thing.
As long as the tank comes in. You?
I might as well just go with the tank.
Okay.
Try at least.
It's regular, so 8. Oh, yeah. 6 and 2.
Oh.
All right. So he can move 9 inches on an advance. He can move 18 on a run, but he can't fire if he runs. He can come down a road and go 18 on an advance.
They still fire with the advance?
Yep. Because it's still an advance. You just get double movement. Okay, so you can still fire. And he's got a light autocannon or a medium machine because it's coaxial, so you can only fire one.
One thing you really see is that squad directly in front of me because the tree blocks your mortar team.
Right, yeah, because it's more than 2 inches of woods.
Yep.
I got a squad here that you can see, but I have hard cover.
Yeah, I'll fire right
see this squad here
directly in front of me.
And from where your gun is, it doesn't really block that. That you're high enough up where that wall's not really gonna affect you. So it's just gonna be the soft cover from the woods because more than half of my squad is behind it.
Yeah, we'll shoot straight to them.
Okay, you're gonna fire the medium machine gun or the light autocannon?
We'll go with the autocannon.
Okay.
Might as well fire it as
HE or you can fire it as armor piercing. Now the other thing too is my guy's down on a 3. So the medium machine gun gets 4 shots. The autocannon gets 2 shots. But the autocannon gets 2 shots if you fired HE, it does D2. So you could actually, say you hit with two, and you roll them again, four fives or sixes, it's an additional hit. So you could get up to four hits at plus one. I like the light autocannon. It's an interesting little...
We'll try the autocannon first.
Yeah, it
might. Worst case scenario, next round I can use a machine.
Grab those big dice for that, because that's a...
You said two, right?
Yep. So you normally need a three, you move four, soft cover would be a five, and you got a 24-inch short range, so you're good to go in the range.
25s.
Yep. Oh, double fours.
Man. Nothing. That's still good, though.
Yeah. Because his medium machine gun can also rip new asses for... I mean, but if you would have hit with that, you would have been killing on two.
Oh, yeah. I got to take a picture of this. This is awesome.
Not good. Not good. Because I don't have a lot to deal with that.
All right.
And you being over there... See, if you would have failed to come in, then maybe I might have went into ambush. Just to, because then, on my next turn,
because
then if any movement happens in front of me, I can trigger. So when you would come in, but now you're like, on the other side of the fucking city.
All right, we'll go with the other inexperienced squad.
Okay.
The rifle squad.
Whoa. So, sevens. Good to go. Six. You still have a lieutenant left.
For all about that guy.
And you have a sniper you haven't activated yet.
Oh yeah, I forgot about him too.
Mm-hmm. That's why the order guys are funny, because sometimes at the end of the turn they'll be like, I still got a dice. What the hell? Oh shit, I got this guy. Running?
Yeah, I'm running.
Okay. Gotta get some bodies in the middle, huh?
Try to.
Yeah, here's that.
Try to get my guys.
Your Japanese would be really good at this. Mission.
I feel bad for not even touching the damn thing.
Hey, I've done it.
But that
when I got all this, when I first got into this, I was like a fanatic for a while, and then I missed that tournament down in Lincoln last year, and I was all bummed, got distracted, and I didn't touch my shit for like 4 months, and then I was like, dude, we should be playing that. Now I'm back into it like hardcore.
That's the way I'm in most of my games.
It happens. That's what's nice.
Now I actually got a decent work schedule. I can actually play on the weekends. And
yeah, what's cool is that actually if we start playing, I work nights too. You say you work nights, right?
Yep.
So a lot of times like this in the day, like afternoon before work, knock out a quick game.
Oh, yeah.
Or even after work, if you get off at midnight and it's summertime, you know, like, shit, come over, we'll have a couple beers and...
I'm totally okay with that.
Play a 500 point game, you know, and just turn on the TV and his kids go to sleep. It's actually nice down here. I like hanging out down here, you know.
I usually hang out in my garage.
Yeah. All right, so all I got is my anti-tank rifle, which is my last best hope for killing that tank. So it's a veteran, so it's a 10, oof. So it'd be a 9. So it comes in. I'm going to advance it because it can move and fire because it's not a fixed team. But I'm not going to have a very good shot, I don't think. Not this turn, but I'm going to... I can't run in this stuff anyway.
You can run along it, though.
Huh?
You can run along it, though, could you? On the side of it?
Right? Well, you can't run through woods either, because they're rough ground. And that would block my fire. So I could come in here to avoid this wall. But it's going to. But that would expose me to when you start shooting at me. I could come in here... and take the penalty until I can move the, up to there. Because once you're manning it, you don't take the penalty. So the choice for me is come in here, avoid the wall, try to get a shot, or just be safe. And I think I'll just be safe. Because I need this to basically tie you up for a couple turns to keep you from sitting there making a lunch meat of my guys. That doesn't mean you can't, well, I mean, you can always move too and get a better shot, but. No, I'm going to go for the, I'll go for the glory. I'll come here. Take the shot while I have it. I am a veteran, so maybe I'll, if you do, and I'm a small team, so I'm hard to hit. All right, so I'm going to come in right there. I'm going to take a picture of that, because this is a pretty good thing. It's a pretty cool looking. Picture right there with that. All right, so I moved four. I have a range on this thing of 36 inches.
Really?
So it's gonna be a long. There's short range. So normally, so the good news is too, that my penetration goes down by one at long range. So actually I'm probably gonna be in your front arc. Cause at long range penetration goes down by one against armored target. So I'm gonna be in your front arc, even though I'm kind of firing from here. They figure the trajectory is not a very good one. So I'm not gonna even be able to hurt you, but I could still pin you.
Oh yeah.
Because I'm a heavy weapon. If I hit you. So normally a three, move four, long range five, and we got this hedgerow,
yeah.
So six. Six, yeah. I'm looking for a six. Just trying to shake you up a little bit.
I like it.
Oh, two. Made you nervous.
It kind of did.
Yeah. Yeah, his job is to...
The last thing I want some gigantic 20 mm shell.
His job is to just keep you from like going da 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 da, you know, and just, I mean, you still may do
the plus side, they can't just roll up, hop out, and get it, kick it in reverse, and roll back down the road.
Who, the tank?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd make it way too easy.
Oh, you should, recce vehicles do. They just go, oh, I'll recce back. Then you have to go down. So the trick is to try to shoot a recce vehicle early, because then it goes down. Alright, so I think we've got one dice left in the bag.
I got two. Here, my sniper team.
Oh, sniper team. So they're both yours.
Well,
oh, I totally forgot about the sniper.
We'll try with the NCO first. What does he need? He needs a...
Boy, I look like a genius coming in here, I think, because 2 inches of woods. If I would have come out here like I was talking about, your sniper would be able to fucking put a bullet in my head.
He can still get some shots off at you.
Maybe. Here's the wood thing. So we'll have to... We can't go through more than 2 inches of woods. I think I'm safe. Come up there.
He's gonna get to you.
Not there.
All
right. Oh, I look like a genius, because I was going to come in here, and I would have been totally exposed.
All right,
Lieutenant?
So what was it?
Well, see, he's inexperienced,
so
but he gets to add his bonus.
Oh.
To himself. So he gets a plus one. So he's back to an eight. And he still fails. So he goes down.
Shoot. All right, now we got the sniper.
Now the sniper.
I don't know who I could really even shoot at.
Well, you basically, since it's a building, you occupy this whole rooftop. As far as your line of fire, it doesn't really make you. The Singalese.
Oh yeah, I didn't even thought about those. We'll fire it then. They have a weird name.
Yep, and they're better than them by a lot. Alright. Let's put them up here just for the dramatic effect. Not too worried about the, because that was only the beginning. I'm not too worried about the 12 inches. Because technically you're 10 inches and then, because you can't move directly to there.
Yeah.
You're about 18 inches away.
And there is... Is it 21 for the range?
It's 36 inches when they're, 36 inches when you're using it as a sniper rifle.
Yep, 36.
Yeah. So 18 inches is short range.
I don't think I'm going to hit short range. Yeah, it's not going to be
so
short.
So it's a long range. So normally a three, long range four. Sniper scope gives you a plus one. So. Back to a three.
And it's one dice, right?
It's one dice. It ignores cover and stuff too, but there's no cover in the way. So three to hit.
Oh, you're kidding me. Damn snipers.
All right, and that's the end of turn one.
I gotta take a picture of this. God damn. People might come out.
Well, it'd be waves if you get next guys to move up, and then the next group coming to the meat grinder. I've got one off the
board. I really like his anti-tank rifle, the way it's pointed up.
The Russians in their squad, normally you can have one per reinforced platoon. Soviet Union can have three per reinforced platoon.
Really?
Yeah. You should get some. Alan has them. He has three of them.
Oh, man.
They're awesome. Even if there's nothing to shoot at, they got a 36-inch range. You got plus two penetration. So you kind of like become a non-scoped sniper. And you blow things' heads off with a plus two. If you happen to hit. And then you've got the three over here.
Yeah, don't remind me.
And I've got one there. You can draw them out now.
Alright.
Trade off. Alright, so.
You want to do your report?
What's that?
You want to do your report?
No, I just record the thing now. And then I'll make a condensed version. And then I'll make a, it takes a little longer to edit out, the kind of the breaks and some of the stuff and do the turns. And I'll just do his talking. I edit out any embarrassing stuff. Personal stuff.
It's all the fun.
Yeah. Well, not the fun, but. I needed a six last time. I didn't move. The building didn't move. So five. Oops. Oops. Back's been going. One. So now I need a four on the next one.
I'm totally okay with that. Be me.
Okay.
Well. We'll just start it off fun with my tank.
Okay.
I want to have a fire. I don't like your anti-tank rifle.
But you got a couple options. You can shoot a machine gun at it, or you can just drive right by it. You can make one turn on an advance, and on a roadway, you can move up to 18 inches. So.
Kind of like when I'm sitting where I'm at this round. I think I'll just shoot right back where I shot the last time.
Okay.
Oh, that's a run.
Yeah, you know I can't blow you up to where you're sitting right now. I can only put a pin on you. But and that's only on a 4-foot, it's only a 50-50 chance.
We're going to use a machine gun this time and fire into that squad.
Okay, so I got the option to go down if I want to. That would be minus one more to hit me. Or just risk it. Oh, jeez. Normally a three, you're not moving. Soft cover. In long range, right?
Yep.
Pretty sure three, four, five. Maybe.
I think it was long range.
We didn't check that. 18. Woo, barely. Inch and a half, 2 inches. So normally a three, long range four, soft cover five.
And four shots, right?
Yeah, so I'm not gonna go down because I need to get to the objective. So go ahead and fire over there. Look at those ones.
Man, it's killing me today.
Good, good, good for me. All right, so that was risky because any of those hits were killing on a 3-0.
That's gonna be you.
I don't want to run too soon because I could end up. I'm going to fire this. I really want to shoot your infantry, but I think the biggest danger is your mortar. I'm going to fire at your mortar.
Okay.
And I'm going to fire indirect.
Okay.
Instead of worrying about the range and the wall and then trying to roll a freaking six or even a five every turn. So I'm going to fire indirect. So I need a six, but then it will subsequently get better. So I'm hoping to do is make your mortar choose to move instead of fire. Or I'm hoping to roll a six, actually.
Nice.
Well, 2d6. You're going to die. Nine hits. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and it's at plus 3, but you're smoked.
Yeah, you're destroyed.
Ah, damn.
Wow.
Took out my mortar team.
So take an order dice out of the bag.
Ooh. That's
put that right there.
That sucks.
That's rough.
What could be worse?
I guess, but so now I've got like, I can sit and just kind of like keep things out of the middle. That thing hits. Yeah. I mean, because you're always like, you can go down when they choose to fire at you, and it will have the hits, but then you're like down. It's like, well, I'm just sitting here waiting for another shot. All right, so I'm gonna run this inexperienced squad right here. So there's 10. All right, so they're run. Let's dice.
Me. Oh, what shall I do? You move up and engage the other guys.
Yeah, you can advance and fire. Or you can.
I think that's what I'll do.
All right.
As well. And six.
Or you could just fire, but then you're not closer to the.
Yeah, thing. I'd rather get close. So it's 6 inches, right?
Yep, and you can go right over the top of that hedge since you're on an advance. Normally, I mean, if you're on a run, you'd have to go around it, but
let's go. All right.
All right.
We're gonna shoot right into those guys.
Shoot those guys?
Yeah.
Sounds good. So rifles have a 24-inch range. Obviously everybody's in range. So it'd be a 12-inch short range. Got like one guy, give you two guys in short. So grab two big dice and we'll roll those. Because you can roll them all together, but we'll 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You have 12 shots. So you need 10 little ones and the two big ones. That give you enough?
Yeah. Sorry, I was just counting.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, so normally you need a 3. You moved, so 4. Long range for everything but the big ones, 5. Inexperienced, 6. And cover, 8. So actually you can roll them all together because you need what's called super sixes.
Yeah.
You need 7 and above is super sixes. 6 followed by a 6. I got 2 starters.
And all these are just done for.
Yep. You're looking for another 6. The super 6s suck. I've thrown so many of those at that tournament trying to hit snipers and stuff. So, not even a hit. Don't worry, I got inexperienced guys too. Moving and firing with inexperienced doesn't work so well. But that's a lot of dice. You never know. 110 on an experienced squad though can change the day because then you fucking failing checks and looking right.
This one's me.
Okay.
I'm gonna try to bring out my machine gun team.
Okay.
That I keep forgetting about the ones over there.
Yeah, I forgot about that too.
I need, was it an 8, wasn't it?
They are regular, so normally 9 should be an 8.
Kill me.
Yeah, because that thing gets set up, man. It can really.
They're gonna be the last squad to come
it's
out.
It's got 36 inch range. You sit there and. I don't want that thing in. I will run my Senegalese. So there's a door right here on a run order. You can run into a building. So I'm gonna just run into the ground floor of this building. I mean, buildings don't help you from a sniper though. And you know, one pin can change the day. And you have to end your turn holding that thing. So. You got a tank right there. If you brought your medium machine gun team in right there, it would have been better, but.
This is you.
Alright, I'll go for this squad. I'll just. Well, they don't have any pins, so I'm gonna just. I'm gonna run them.
look so good, but those inexperienced die so horribly fast.
I got my guys.
Okay.
Oh, I'll try to bring in those guys over there.
That's a regular squad. Because you got your two inexperienced in, right?
That's my LMG squad.
So they're actually regulars, so they're like elite in this game. Good to go. Yeah, regulars like elite in this game compared to all these inexperienced troops.
Oh, where do I want to bring him? I don't know how long I do them.
Well, you can advance in and fire, or you can run 12 inches.
Okay, where do I advance them in at, though? That's the thing.
Oh, yeah. I mean, what's your goal? Try to get a shot on something?
I just want to get them in there.
Or get them in.
So I can move them like right in here, but I don't think they'll be in range to hit anything.
Well, 24 inches. So if you come in, you're going to have hard cover about everywhere, though, too.
Yeah. Oh, great. Lord's running in.
That's probably the best bet. That way they're in a position to do multiple things next turn, as opposed to coming in and looking for a long-range pin.
Yeah.
Because I don't have the mission, the plans, you know. So even if I go first, actually, if you go first, you could run and grab them, you know. And then I'll have to get them away from those fucking fanatics. That would be bad. That would be really bad, actually. Because, yeah, that would suck. I need to get the plans first. But then it's not going to keep us from... With that little gap right there, there's a lot of potential for some close combats that would be ugly.
So my goddamn machine gun team, fuck, come out like Saving Private Ryan when they just storm the beach. Well, damn MG42 that I lost.
See, I kind of ran in front. I should have ran this squad first. Then I could have had an option to move this one to fire. Can't fire within an inch of your own guys. So I'll just run this squad too. I'm just gonna pack them all in there. I do got a decent amount of firepower in these squads because I got that light machine gun. They can't hit the broadside of a barn if they're moving.
I was looking at my guys today.
Yeah, moving inexperienced. You're starting off on a 5. I'll advance this team so I can get to the wall. I don't think I'm going to make it this time, but at least I'm starting to work my way towards your side armor, you know. But I can shoot, because that's not a fixed team. So I'm still in your front arc. Normally near 3. Moved 4. Yeah, short range now. And soft cover. So 5. 3, move 4, soft cover 5. So I just made it to short range. 2. No pins. I'm letting you know I'm there.
I'll be coming away. That's me. Alright. I think I'll use my snipers.
Okay.
And I can pretty much shoot a
360, yeah. Rifle or one of these squads?
Well, that rifle's probably a pain in the ass to even try to hit.
No, because it ignores cover. The only thing it does, small team does affect them, and range affects them. And if I was down, that would affect them.
Yeah.
So normally I'm hitting on a 3. If we're at short range, you're hitting starting off on a 2 with the sniper scope, small team 3.
Yeah, fuck.
Range would be 4 if we're at long range.
I'll try and screw it.
Yeah, snipers are pretty sweet because they ignore all cover.
Yeah.
Alright, so we are at long. So normally a three, no, normally a two because the sniper scope. So small team three, long range four. Hitting on a four up.
Oh, Lord. It's killing me today.
I'm glad I gave you those darts. I am a veteran, so it would have been hard to kill me, but you would have put a pin on me. And I'm just kind of saturating the whole, like, what do you shoot at? You know, you got one shot, what do you shoot at?
Yep.
I'm going to try to bring that team in that failed, so I need an eight. I guess I'll run right there. This will be my sniper suppression squad next turn. So just randomly firing up there, needing sevens. I'll run this turn. Started trying to figure out what I want to do for the bases on these. I did this one. I don't like it at all.
Oh, that gravel?
Yeah. Well, like the gravel's fine. That's how I normally gravel my stuff. I thought, I'm going to try a green and then like a light. And then I put the grass in. I'm like, nah. I want to do something different. So I'm going to just sit like tomorrow and just play with different color combinations. I've got some green, maybe a green with a light green on top, and I'm not a big fan of the green bases, but I want to do something different, because I based my British and my Germans kind of the same. It looks nice, but I want something light to really kind of highlight the miniature. So, with that dark and the heavy and the greens, I don't know.
Camo's running through sand almost like on a beach.
Yeah, it's France or French. I'm trying to think of something like spring, because that's pretty much how long they were in the war.
Yeah.
One spring, 1 month.
Well, they pretty much got like, well, it'll be grass pretty much.
Yeah.
Or so, you could put them like a French well, village.
See, I got some of these cheap paints from Walmart.
That's actually the paints that I use.
Yeah. So I'm gonna try the green with a light, like a bright, lightish kind of greenish. And then when I put this flocked sand or the flocked grass on, there's kind of a dead in my contrast. So I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna just play with different color combinations tomorrow until I get something that I like.
All right, now we got me. I'm gonna move these guys. I think I'm just gonna advance them.
If you run, you can go into that bottom of that house, and then next turn you'd be set.
Yeah, I didn't even think about it. I had the doors right there.
Yeah,
I had the doors on the front of that one.
Yeah, this
one. Probably my thing has the one on the front. Oh, that one over there. Yeah, I guess I can run them in. Ain't gonna hurt nothing.
Yeah, I mean, it just gives you a next turn bit, power play. You can either fire out all those windows, or you can charge out, you know, if you need to.
No one rushes. They're just gonna sit here and get drunk.
That's possible. Fight a keg in there.
Honestly, don't blame them. If I was in this war, I'd be getting hammered every day, too.
That's probably a quarter potato and a thing of vodka for your ration.
Yeah, probably.
And then they take that potato and make more vodka. Yeah, I think that's because if you would have advanced up, you only would have got a few shots, I think, from the angle.
Yeah. What else do I have? Oh, my guy over there.
Your lieutenant?
I forgot all about him.
He forgot about you too.
Jesus Christ. That guy's worthless.
You didn't even want him. I was like, hey, you have to take a lieutenant. Oh, yeah.
He
resents that. I have my lieutenant. Brave lieutenant.
Rick.
He's just gonna run. He's running back here behind this.
Yeah, I'm blue.
House right there. Alright, that's turn two.
Thank you.
games are kind of fast. I kind of like it.
So do I.
And knock one out. I mean, and then, you know, it's kind of refreshing for you, but if after you've played this one, you'll be like, oh yeah, I got it. If we ever played another small 500 point game, you know, we could knock one out really fast.
I just need to download the damn rule books online.
Dice. Pick up the dice thing. Oh, that's going to take a picture too.
A machine gun team, my lieutenant, are a bunch of cowards.
You want me to pull them out this time?
If you want.
I've got that book, but I will for you. Okay. And boom. Me. Shit. If I grab that thing too soon, everything will just shoot the people who have it. I think I better... I'm just gonna fire right here. The odds of me killing anybody are low because you're in a building. But I'm gonna try. So I've got a light machine gun. It's three shots. One guy has to help him. And I've got one, two, three, four, five, six other shots. Five, six. Now one of those is a VB launcher. I'm going to try to shoot it. Because I never fired one before. So I'll grab a yellow dart for that. Now the VB launcher is like a mortar. It has a 6-inch minimum range. So I can fire.
Barely.
It's got an 18-inch maximum range. So it fires like a mortar. So I'll fire that first. It needs a 6. And it actually goes up just like I was saying. So it needs a 6.
Lucky.
But then we would have to roll to see what floor it detonated on.
probably the roof.
Yeah, probably that. Alright, so these guys are regular. So normally I need a 3. Actually, I need a 4 because I'm inexperienced. Hard cover, so sixes already. Nobody's at point blank, because point blank gives you plus one, like a sniper scope. So I need sixes to hit. You could go down to make it sevens, but I wouldn't recommend it, since I need sixes to wound you too, because you're in a building. And you need to. So I got two hits. So you take a pin, and you can use those glass beads if you want, those little black beads.
Oh, there's one some here?
Yep. Yeah, just grab one, throw it on there.
Just put it right there. Yep.
And I need a 6 to wound you. Because even though you're inexperienced, which are normally 3s, you're in a building, so it's 6s. I didn't kill anybody. But I put a pin on you.
Got lucky there.
Yeah, you will murder me back the other way. So I'm hopeful that if I can get a couple pins on you, that you'll fail an order check or something, because you'll be killing, you'll be hitting me. I only got soft cover and I die on 3s. Not good. Great.
All right, we might as well just start with them.
Okay.
Might as well. I'm just gonna fire.
You gotta make an order check now because I put a pin on you.
And that's 2 dice, right?
Yep. Just like coming in from reserve. So normally you're inexperienced, so you're 8. And you have a pin marker, so a 7. Yes! That's why I fired first. Because you would have murdered me back. You would have been hitting on 5s. Normally a 3, experience 4, soft cover 5.
Little bastards.
Little bastards. So just that little spook of rifles just made them duck down. And gray. One of the things in this game is leadership, and it's hard at 450 points to field an army that has any substance. But so you take the inexperience, and you get more bodies. But leadership checks.
We're gonna run them right up to this.
Advance.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't feel like breaking those damn bayonets.
Yeah, just stick them in there.
I can almost just run right through this gap almost. Actually, I could, right up to the bottom of that tank.
Can you touch, if you can make it there, then if you touch it, you can grab the plants.
He's right here, wasn't he?
I trust you.
Right there.
I trust you.
I don't think he's right on it, actually. I think he's right on the edge of the road.
Okay.
From what it looks like for me. But we'll put him right there anyways. Right.
So you can't quite get the plants. You could have run ordered, but then you'd sacrifice shooting.
Yeah, I'd rather shoot.
Just move him up to where you move.
Alright. Now I'll start cranking off some rounds.
Let's bring them up here a little bit so they keep their squad cohesion.
Alright. So, the question is who do I want to shoot at?
Yeah, from right there.
Can I shoot over that tank?
You sure can, but it's going to give me hard cover.
Yeah, I don't want to give you too much. I can put that squad right next to it. Want to mix that?
This one here?
Yeah. That'd be hard cover too. Kind of, I guess it would be because
it's the majority of so you'd have basically, you have some split modifiers. So all these guys would have no cover, right? And then all these guys would be firing at hard cover. So you just roll two sets of dice, or you could shoot these guys with, but they've already activated, but you'd be hitting them with just a soft cover.
Yeah.
Inexperienced movement too, as you gotta remember.
We'll try it, those guys over there against that wall.
Okay, so grab 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dice, and we'll roll these without the hard cover.
5, okay.
So normally it's your inexperienced, so 4. Moved 5. That's gonna be it for them. So one hit, that's a pin.
Here, I got one right here. Oops.
And then put that off to the side, and we'll 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more dice, and these ones are going to need supers because of the hard cover.
Yeah. All right, here we go. 1,
and then we're going to roll another 6 after that. So one hit, killing these guys on a 3-up.
Ooh,
so picked one up.
So we got one.
Got a guy. First dead frog. Alright. But those pins can be critical, as we've just seen. Greg and
yeah.
Initiative 2.
Okay. I think I will. I think I'm going to advance these guys.
Okay. Move
these guys up.
Yeah. And they don't have the -1 for the inexperienced.
But I can shoot them at least somebody.
Yeah. I'm gonna. There's a couple people have the Flames of War template. It's this hard, kind of this 6-inch long hard plastic thing, and then it's got a 90-degree angle on it. It's got a 1-inch tapered end.
Really?
Yeah. It's like, I need one of those because it's great for this, because they just put it down like that and they move to the end of it.
Huh.
And then to check to see if you're within an inch of your own troops, you just put it down like that.
Like, oh, that's actually kind of cool.
Yeah. Like, I need one of those. That's so simple.
All right, we will shoot at. We'll go over these guys right there.
Okay. So just look at the majority of the models are not in any hardcover because I don't have enough behind that wall from you. So it's just going to be the soft cover.
Where's that LMG guy at? Isn't that squad I had him in?
That's your light machine gun squad.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. He may not have put a model in there.
Right,
just say it's whoever. I don't care.
Yeah, just pick one. The one without a bayonet.
Okay. So range is right at long. So long range for everything except the light machine gun, because that's got a 30-inch range, so it gives it a 15 short range. So we'll roll those separate. Normally a 3.
So how many dice do I need all the other?
3 for the light machine gun.
Okay, we'll do the machine gun first.
So normally 3, move 4, and then just soft cover.
So 5.
So 5 for the light machine gun shots. That's one hit. And then, so one guy has to help load. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rifle shots. And they'll need 6s. Normally a 3, move 4.
You said 8, right?
Yeah. Normally it's be move 4, soft cover 5, long range for that 6s. And another hit.
Look at those bags. Look at this bag.
Oh my god, some of this little thing here too.
Alright, so I got these. Whoops, wrong squad. Right? No, that's right.
That's right.
I got these handy dandy little things from my British. They're pretty cool.
I haven't seen a lot of those online.
Yeah, I'm gonna order some more. I'm gonna get some from my friend, because then you just, you know, one pin, two pins, three. And it just looks pretty cool. I'm gonna order some French flag ones. Alright, so got two hits on me.
Yep.
So you're killing them on threes. One boy dead. Alright. It's like dink, dink, and then things just start dying in droves. Because now you won't have to move, you know? Yep. And then it's like, good, I'll go down. I need to activate. If you failed, start failing you checks because of those pins.
Alright. We're going to try the machine gun squad.
Okay.
I mean, you did an 8, so I'm not going to fail.
Hey! They got it exactly!
Oh man,
so they can run like an infantry. They can advance, but they can't fire because they're a fixed team. So get them to where you want them.
I guess I can run them in this building.
Yeah, six. Like you said, and then go up to the second floor if you want. That way you can fire over your own guys' head. That's a nice spot. Heave that thing up. Yeah, because normally down here you wouldn't be able to fire an inch past your own troop, yep, but up there you can. Oh boy. Don't want that. Don't want that going into play. Me, I'm gonna go for a 6 on it.
Uh-oh.
I can see it.
I forgot about that damn thing.
Alright, I need a 6. But done. Indirect.
That'll probably.
But it is 2, so if I do hit, I have to see if it hits on the top floor or goes below, because it's a building. Oh,
one. See, that one should blow up in their face.
That's why I used to play Orc and Goblins for fantasy. This shit did blow up in their face.
Really?
Yeah. It broke, you know, it'd break and stuff. Called a misfire. So then it drift off or hit your own stuff. Me. I'll fire this thing. Just popping away. You know, 4 now to hit that rooftop or wherever that building. That's a 3.
Oh, man.
The indirect, though, it does, you almost start to feel like, ugh. And then when it starts to,
I don't like it.
Yeah, being a building makes it better because at least it doesn't automatically hit you. It might travel through.
Yeah.
But, all right. Great. All right. But it still sucks.
I think it's time for the tank.
Time for the tank.
I think we're going to move them up.
Okay.
Advances 8.
9.
9.
But it's double on a rope.
So I want to move and shoot. I don't want
to. Ooh, that is.
No, I don't like that. Damn tank rifles right there. I keep forgetting about him. I forgot all about him. I think we're going to move him.
Because you can go 18 on if you stay on the road. Because it's double move.
Yeah, but then my rear is. Well, is the rear armor pretty good?
It's minus 2. So it's 6. It's bad.
I don't give you too much help. Screw it. I'm gonna go up to here.
At least you do have a turret, so you can actually, you can turn. You can make one turn on an advance.
And then turn it there.
Or you could turn it towards me.
Oh yeah.
And traverse your turret that way.
That'll work.
Like that.
So I'm still facing the front.
Yep, because the armor is to the front, but the guns are off to the side. And like, if you do a fire order with a tank, it's not counting as movement and shooting if you're just spinning your turret.
Yeah. And then I'm gonna shoot the auto cannon this time.
Okay.
And we'll shoot it. We'll just shoot that unit straight in front of me.
These guys here?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's
pop 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 boom.
Was it 2?
Yeah, it's just 2 shots, but it does D2 if they hit. You're definitely at short range. So normally you're 3. You moved 4. I think I've got hard cover.
I think you do too.
Okay. So 6s.
Six total.
But you're look at the spot you're in though now. So, because I have to stop and grab that.
Yep.
And somebody's going to get fucking raped.
I still have my goddamn mortar. I need to take out that damn thing. That thing I'm worried about. I didn't shoot anywhere on the damn map.
Right. Well, it can only shoot what it can see. And if it fires indirect, it's a six. I can't fire past my own troops, you know, so you start to.
I wonder if my sniper could hit him.
36 inch range.
Oh, he's way out of range, yeah. I bet. I can almost guarantee he's out of range.
Just pretty cool. This is a pretty cool views, though, I'll tell you. You know, you really start to feel the World War II cinematic stuff. So you got a fire sniper or something?
Yeah, I think I'm going to shoot at your anti-tank rifle again. Oh. I'll just try.
Almost like one of those things where there's so much to shoot at, you know.
I keep forgetting my guys have those as Molotov cocktails.
Yep, those guys. That's against vehicles.
Oh, I can't use one on other people?
No. You don't need to, though. I mean, yeah, close combat is different. I mean, if you get charged, the attacker always goes first, but if you're defending an obstacle like they are right now, then it's simultaneous.
Yeah, I remember that.
You can come over a wall and go 12 inches. Normally you can't run over a wall, but on a assault move, if you're manning it, you can go 12 inches. So, or you can go around it to go 12 inches. You can't, yeah. But, yeah, you're in a pretty good spot right there, actually, you know, to counter me grabbing that thing or whatever. I'm going to have to do something to distract that squad. All right. So, normally a three, it was long range, right?
Yeah.
By a little bit. Shot, yeah.
Oh,
three again. That long range, that like inch and a half is.
Oh, even short range is killing me. I think the rest is all you.
I don't think I'll fire, just to go for a pin on that thing. Normally a three. Probably that wall, so five. No guaranteed hit by any means. Fire your tank.
So, oh, nice.
So I can't hurt. Well, I can at short range.
You are short range.
Yeah, so because I get plus two at short range. Definitely short range. You have an eight front armor. So I need a six to glance you.
Yep.
You do take a pin.
Damn pins.
So I need a six to glance.
No. Oh.
And a glance means that it's you roll the damage chart minus three. So there's really no, there's almost no way to like blow you up, but it could immobilize you.
Oh yeah.
It could catch you on fire, which you could fail that morale check and die. Or usually the result is crew stun, take an additional pin. Is it all me?
Yeah, I think it was
all. No, you got one left.
Do I?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
The guy lieutenant.
Guy that wants to join the battle.
Yeah.
He's a sissy.
Alright, so now we got some decisions.
Yeah, this is where it's gonna get crazy.
Alright, first thing I think I'm gonna do, only one squad can occupy a building, so I gotta either move my Senegalese out or move my lieutenant out here into sniper zone. I think you got enough on your plate right now. So I'm gonna advance my lieutenant, or run him, because I wanna make sure that these guys pass. Not that it's guaranteed. See, just forcing the check is what's important on those things, you know?
Yeah.
So I'll go to here. There's my lieutenant. And then... Alright, so I'm going to go with this squad that's down a man. And I'm going to... try to activate him on an A. Yeah, there's a squad there, a squad there. They already gone. These guys are coming up. I will try to advance that squad. So they're inexperienced eight. They have a pin seven, but now the lieutenant gives them the plus one, so back to an eight. Six. So I clear the pin. Get to advance 6 inches. All
pushing right to you.
Yeah. Your orders are to keep the Russians back with your lives. They can shoot because it's an advance order, so maybe I'll.
You might be able to take. You probably take out a lot.
Well, let's see. I think you're still gonna have. That's cool. If I fire at this squad, the majority. You think soft cover from there?
Yeah, it has to be soft cover. That thing ain't tall enough.
Well, it's tall enough is okay, but I think I got the majority of the squad over on this side. So I'll fire it into them. So normally need a 4 because I'm inexperienced. I moved 5, but I'm point blank. And then soft cover 6. But I'm point blank, so back to a 5. God, inexperience are horrible. Normally it's 3. Inexperience 4. Mood 5. Soft cover 6. Point blank 5. But I got a decent amount of shooting. Let's see. So 3 for the light machine gun. And one guy has to help him. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 other guys. And I'm going to fire a VB launcher at your tank. Because since it's a heavy weapon, you can split fire as long as the heavy weapon goes against a vehicle.
Nice.
I mean,
I like it.
Yeah, I need a 6, but a pin would be great. Alright, so the yellow one is the VB launcher. Looking for 5s on the squad. You can't go down in because you advanced.
Ooh, Yahtzee.
2, 3, 4.
Wow.
Oof. So they get a pin.
Yeah. I didn't expect to get that many 5s. And they're inexperienced, so kill him on a 3.
Oh, just one?
Fuck, all those hits?
Full series guy right here.
Yeah. He caught all the bullets in the chest.
Yeah, pretty much. That's what happens when you scream.
And I missed with the VB launcher. And it's only +1 penetration, but your armor is a 7 on the top, so I could theoretically glance you on a 6.
Yeah.
I was really just looking for the pin. Me again. And I've never taken these type of VB launcher things before, so it's kind of new.
It's fun to experiment with.
Alright, I'm going to advance this squad. Oh wait, I gotta check. Now that I moved him, I probably cursed myself. Cause they have a pin on them.
After I have a
pin. So they're normally a 9. I mean, they're normally an 8 because they're inexperienced. 7, but back to an 8. Whew, snake eyes. Okay. Usually when I move that after I, then it's like I almost always fail that check. So I'll advance, and they don't have a whole lot of good shots though.
You got the guys in the building too.
Yeah, I'm saving them to grab the token. So I will shoot over here. You're gonna have hard cover though. But I've got almost everybody except one at point blank. And he's gonna be the guy, he's helping load the machine gun. So I've got 3 for the light machine gun, one guy helping. And 4 shots, I'm going to do the VB launcher trick again. So 4, and then 3 for the light machine gun.
And then your VB launcher.
And the VB launcher at the tank again, because he's right here and I can see you. And it's a minimum range of 6, maximum range of 18. So he's just at 18.
Yeah.
Alright, so against the people, normally you have 3, moved 4. Inexperienced 5, hardcover 7, but I'm at point blank, so 6. No bueno. I mean, being that close. And a 6, so everything's 6s. Looking for a 6 on the yellow dice, too. Holy shit, dude!
God damn.
I'm fucking lighting it up!
Fucking
goddamn Russians.
That's 5 sixes. Now let's see if I can...
fucking squad.
Well, I gotta get threes. Horrible on kill shots, though. Gotta switch dice out. Burn up all the sixes.
I can't even roll. My guys are just getting fucking annihilated.
Alright. Got another dice. I'll advance these guys. Or I'll just try to shoot from right there. I'm in these sevens either way, so I'll advance. So, 3 for the light machine gun. One guy helping. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of the dice. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'll fire the BB launcher as well. At the sniper. 18 inch. Yeah. Alright, so I need super sixes on that. And a 6 on the yellow. So, it's actually better. One possible. Nope. No hit. No joy.
You missed my lieutenant. Your
lieutenant? Isn't he like a 9?
Oh, Jesus Christ. I think that was the last one, wasn't it?
I think he's going to have a visit from the commissar at the end of this. And I got one left, and it's my Senegalese guys. So they're going to advance. You can move through your own troops. You just have to stop an inch away. I'm going to come out. I'm going to grab the secret plans. All right. Turn 4.
That looks so bad. They're all converging on each other.
Yeah. I'm glad you don't have an airstrike or freaking artillery bombardment.
You still got that damn thing over there. Oh, the view from this machine gun nest is pretty sweet.
Yeah, that's... yeah. That fucking guy's gonna tear some asshole up if I,
I gotta check this one out.
Oh, sweet. That's a nice shot.
It is.
That's pretty cool.
That's the only I like about this new phone.
Yeah, that's a nice ass camera on that thing. What is that?
It's a Note 5. Nice. Even with a tank view looks sweet.
You have to put those on the Bolt Action Nebraska page. I might use some of those on some of my YouTube intros. That's a fucking pretty sweet looking picture.
Yeah, you can do one, I don't care. The one with a tank right on top of the turret.
Yeah, nice. God, he's got such a... I'm glad that doesn't have more guns in it.
Although that medium machine gun comes into play. I think that medium machine gun's more dangerous to my inexperience, because the autocannon's great against vets, because it's like, oh, I get some extra penetration. But you don't need anything against these guys. And then your lieutenant.
Fucking lieutenant.
Alright, but pretty close on the order dice still.
Hey, I want an off one. So far.
Alright, it's up to you. Now the key is, what I love about this game, is key is like, what are you going to activate first?
Yep.
Because it's like, they don't have any pins, so you know they're going to pass. But do I want to activate them or go for them? Because these guys are fanatic.
Yep.
Close combat guys, but you gotta pass an order check.
You go first.
Oh, god damn it.
I think I will run.
Yeah, I figured you would.
That is huge, because what I was thinking was, if you're gonna assault, if you assault the Senegalese, you can, but I'd be defending an obstacle. So at least we'd go Simo, and I'd try to kill as many of you as possible. You would end up probably winning. Just because you have the strength in numbers. If you assaulted one of these other guys, they wouldn't go first.
Yeah.
And you could go and just obliterate them.
I can't really do much here, singly now. You're pretty much done.
Well, you got a tank.
Yeah, we gotta move it then.
Yeah, you're gonna have to. I mean, you can, if you pass, you can advance up to here, you know, and fire and try to put pins. It'd be hard for you to get a win now, but you can easily get a draw by just getting some pins. That order dice is pretty bad.
Alright, now mine goes.
So this turn, you can look at eliminating those two squads, and then hoping you draw early. I don't think I can get off the board. No, not by just close.
I can still move my tank up, though.
You still got your tank. You got your two infantry squads. You got a... Check him safe from the sniper. But, yeah, I mean, you can set the next turn. Basically, if you pass here and assault, kill them, and then consolidate, you know, close, the hope to draw, the one you take an order dice out, these guys advance up or assault either one, kill them off, take another order dice out. Start to relieve your balance for, like, when you pull out the next one, then your squads have done that, and then you got the tank still too, so you still got things. It's just, I just made it a lot more difficult getting that first order dice.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna use,
because if I wouldn't have got that first order dice, you could have hit them with the medium machine gun, hit them with the medium machine gun, hit them with the sniper. It's like, fuck.
I'm gonna use the machine gun.
Okay,
so they wait so long to get them out.
Yeah, there's no rush here now, you know. I'm activated, I can't take it any farther,
and I'll just shoot those guys right there.
Okay,
and you said it was five. Six
dice, yeah. And I've just got soft cover. I don't want to go down because it's short range. So normally at three, fours, I'm not going to go down. That would make it fives, but I'd be stranded there. So need fours.
Need two.
So that's kind of underwhelming. But you're killing on threes.
Ah, man.
Jeez Louise, you gotta go buy your own set of dice.
These Russians are sucking.
You gotta go buy your own set of dice. But it's a pin. I fired out of the medium machine gun last time. Neither one of us have moved, so I'm gonna get a five this turn. But let's see, one, two, or three, it travels through to the next floor. So you're hoping for a one, two, or three. Two! So it doesn't hurt them at all, but it just blew every window out of that thing. Oh, I can, if I roll boxcars, I'll collapse the building. Because 12 heavy howitzers roll 3d6.
Yeah.
So if I do roll boxcars, the building actually implodes on itself.
It'd be stressing.
It would be pretty cool. You'll be dead.
That'd be a pretty cool story.
Ooh, I got half of it.
I got half of it.
Oh man.
So they're crazy. Okay. They don't even take a pin. But I'm hitting now. I'm hitting that building on two up. So.
God. No time to move over, man. You again.
Alright. Better try to activate these guys, I guess. Should I move my lieutenant up first? See if we get too fancy and end up wasting order dice. I'm gonna try to activate them on a fire order. So they're normally an 8, so they're a 7 because of the pin from the machine gun. Fuck. See, the machine gun did its job. Pinned them down. So they go to down. Next dice.
Damn, that's nice. You again.
Gonna get a pin on that squad over there. Don't make you fail. These guys don't have a pin, so I will. If I assault you, we go Simo. I have 7 guys. 7. I'm gonna fucking assault you.
Yeah.
You're gonna win, but I'm hoping to just grind you down to.
That's awesome.
Alright, so. The one thing it does for you is it removes your pin markers.
That's, yeah, we're gonna make this look cool.
Yes.
It's like a fucking shield wall. That's fucking awesome.
Let's see how it goes. I'm just trying to grind you down. You know, so you're not able to have a whole lot of firepower and shoot at my singly. So somebody blows a. This is my British Expeditionary Force guys, you know, they're like, whoop, blow that whistle, like in the, go, if I was really British, I'd actually have some special rules, but now I'm on the French list, so, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 guys.
I got 9.
None of us have any submachine guns, which would give us extra attacks. The good news is for you, even if I roll great, you're fanatic, so you don't die until you don't know the last name.
Nice.
So normally, close combats, whoever gets the most wounds, auto wins. If I would roll 2, and you would roll 1, I win, your squad's wiped out, normally. But you're fanatic, so they don't do that. If you roll 2, and I roll 1, then no matter, even if I had 5 guys left, they surrender or they're considered dead. All right, so we're looking, we're both sucked. We both need 3s. 3s kill things.
All right, let's do this.
Like if I was veterans, you know, that's where it really comes in handy.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So you win the combat, and I only had, 7 guns anyway.
No. Oh.
So, but you, I killed 6 of you.
6?
Yeah, and I rolled no 6s. If I rolled a 6, I could roll. Try to roll another 6.
They got fucking toasted there.
Yeah, yes, that's the whole idea. Being inexperienced is painful. Now, if you're running that free and experienced squad later, if you can get a charge, like if you would have charged me where I didn't have a defended obstacle, you would go first. Going first is huge because then you get to throw all your dice, take off the casualties. Like what you just rolled, you just rolled 7 dead. Yeah. So I would have been dead. I don't even have a strike back. That's why I wanted to try to kill you first or knock you down.
That was awesome.
Fucking bodies strewn all over the street. And that's an order dice out for me. We'll put it right there. All right.
Who's next? You again.
And that's one thing I went on the Warlord forums. What I've been doing is rolling. It wouldn't apply to you because you're fanatics. I've been rolling more than 50% casualties after close combat. They said that's wrong. So it's something that I've been doing that I shouldn't have been. I've been kind of hurting myself on that. Okay. Oh, you got a squad in that fucking building still, don't you?
Yep.
You little fucker. I totally forgot about those guys. Oh, shit. I'm going to shoot at them. Because they failed last time. Maybe I'll get them to fail again. So three for the machine gun. One guy helping. One, two, three, and five. And I got my VB launcher. Give me a yellow. Yeah, right. That's hitting on a five now. Woohoo! So normally a three, hardcover five. I need fives now, as opposed to whatever sixes I needed last time. And this is a five as well, because it goes down one better. Two hits. So that's a pin, which is what's important. And I kill on sixes, because you're inside there. I killed one.
Got one. Nice.
I rolled another six, I get to pick who I want. I just took off the NCO. That'd be a permanent minus one morale.
Up again.
Russian, God, make him fail.
Russian cowards.
At least he got a bullet in him.
Lieutenant's off eating, drinking tea somewhere. Chicken shit. I'm to see you again.
Okay.
Jesus.
What to do? God, I totally fucking forgot about that squad. Now that would have been a rude awakening. I don't really have any other shots on that building though. Put pins. Those guys going down really kind of sucks. Alright, I'll advance this squad. They don't have any pins. And this secret mission scenario, I didn't really get to employ my light machine gun, 30-inch range, VB launcher, dropping all of the defensive strategy that I was planning. It's more like, run, 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 run. Alright, I'll shoot. I don't know how much. I'm not checking range. I'm just gonna. Really can't fire at them because my guy, my stupid guys are down. So I'll just shoot at that sniper. Okay, so normally I need fours. Small team five. I need sevens no matter what. So no sense in even checking the range. So I should have eight shots. Three, with one guy helping. Six, seven, eight shots and a VB launcher needing a six. And super sevens on the blue. Super six. So one possible. No. Yeah. Needing sevens is crap. It's like when you're playing those Americans, it's like, okay, I move. No movement penalty, you know?
Yeah.
That's pretty powerful. Cause you could actually run an American inexperienced list that would actually be viable because you don't take the movement penalty. So it's almost like you're taking a movement. Light mortar. Fire it. Needing a three now.
Three.
Alright, one, two, or three, it passes through to the next floor. So I'm looking for a four, five, six. Yes.
There it goes.
But it's not very powerful. It's only.
They get a pin, don't they?
They'll take a pin.
You should have a sniper, right?
Yes. And it's HE D3. So I roll a D3 to see how many hits. So there'd be a two. So two hits, and it's at plus one. Since you're on the roof, it's not six ups. Well, HE ignores buildings anyway. That's one nice thing too.
Yeah.
If you're like got guys camped in a building, you hit them with that mortar or a howitzer or let's say an assault gun. Yeah, it ignores that six up. So, but it's plus one, and you are a regular. So I'm killing on a three up. Normally a four plus one three up. Killed one. If I happen to roll a six, another six, like an exceptional damage. I could have actually picked the sniper. So one guy down, that's a
damn.
That's a break check for that unit because it's a 50% casualty.
Yep. Son of a bitch.
And now it's a small team down to the last man. So normally you're nine, eight for the pin, and a seven because now you have a permanent minus one modifier.
Yeah, roll it now.
Yeah, two dice. You're looking for a seven or less. You're fine. Although it will affect your shooting, a minus one, so basically nerf your sniper scope.
Yeah, pretty much. Me.
Because he doesn't have his spot.
All right, I'm going to activate my A. We're going to go for the tank.
Activate T-60 tank.
We need to activate that.
He's got one pin, so it'd be an 8, because he's normally a 9. Ah, darn it. I almost tried to shoot him again and put another pin, but I was saving it because I don't want you to just go fucking driving here without at least taking a side shot.
Alright.
It was like, put another pin on and probably not damage it. Make it myself a threat. I'm glad that doesn't
matter. Right?
Yep, 9 inches. You can drive right over that wall.
Oh, I can't.
Yeah, you're tracked. You can turn one time, so plan your turn accordingly.
I can just go straight ahead.
You can go, yeah, 6 inches to there, and then turn if you wanted, or straight to 9, or whatever you want to do. Oh, yeah, you got a turret, so you can go.
Yeah, let's go to 9.
Yep.
Go right there.
So,
and he is gonna fire.
Yeah, darn it. That's a pretty good move right there. Because no cover. A little bit farther back, I would have had more. Alright, so normally a 3.
I'm gonna use the 4. I'll use the machine gun.
Okay.
Try to take out more of them. That's 4, right?
Put a pin on. Yeah, 4 shots. Normally a 3. Move 4. That's the only thing.
1.
1 hit. Good thing you use the machine gun. Alright, and you're killing these guys on a 4-up, because they're regulars. Nobody died. It's all about the pin, though.
Hey, I gotta pass my mark. Me again. I'm gonna activate these guys.
Okay.
I think we're just gonna... We're gonna charge.
Sounds good.
It sounds fun.
Yeah.
Might as well.
Now... See, the thing with these guys is, I never made it to the wall. So you don't have to charge the wall. Where normally you have to take the closest path to get, but that wouldn't actually get to me because you can't run over a wall. So you go this way and you'll actually be striking first as opposed to me defending an obstacle.
So yeah, just kind of go through here.
Everybody's counted as being in. Yeah, if I would have been a little, if I wouldn't have failed that check, I was just going to advance like a quarter inch, be manning the wall, put some shots out, and at least...
So that's the thing about doing the shots, but since those guys are already on the run...
No, yeah, this is... But, and see, when you kill them, you get to consolidate these 6 inches. So you can actually boost your movement, you know?
All right, so there's...
Not good.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
If we went simo, I might have a chance to knock you down, but you're gonna slaughter me. And if I hadn't had an activation, I could have done a reactionary fire.
Yeah.
But
all right,
you're killing me on threes.
Ugh, out of threes.
1, 2. That's enough to kill the squad.
Yep. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's what I have. 7. Not even a strike back.
And then you have to move 6 inches?
D6. So you roll a 6 out of dice?
Oh, yeah. 6 out of dice. 4.
So you move 4 inches in any direction. Yeah, wait till the points levels get a little higher. You can start putting some submachine guns and stuff and take some regular troops as opposed to inexperienced. Like a submachine gun squad.
I was actually looking at that with the on that website you sent me for the 1200 point army.
Mm-hmm.
I was actually thinking, I was like, screw it, I can do 1200 points full of tanks. But I don't want to do that. That would just be for fun.
Yeah, I do want to try to put together a tank war game.
See, I was thinking about that too. I'm like, that would be awesome.
That would be pretty fun. I've never played a tank war. Never really had enough tank. I got enough German tank. It would be a weird lit. It'd be like a Panzer IV.
Tanks and tanks.
And a Hetzer. Oh, I got a Jager Panzer. That's pretty cool.
It's still be fun.
Alright. Old Soviet Union striking back.
Alright, me again. We'll go with the guys in the building. Well, let's see if we can activate them first.
Yep.
And I need a...
Normally, they're the inexperienced ones, right?
Yep.
So they're normally at 8, so 6, because you got 2 pins. So you remove 1 pin, and they get to do whatever you want them to.
Or they can actually move now?
They can do whatever, advance, fire, whatever, they pass, just as if they didn't. They still carry a pin, so they'll take minus one shooting, but.
We're in advance. They can go around the front door, can't
yep.
they?
Yep. They come out the windows and the door.
Right to you.
You can run and assault me if you want.
That'll work too. I'll just do that.
Do that?
Running.
Yeah. So you'll remove your pin when you make contact. I am defending a hedge this time though. Because you can't circumvent it unless
yeah. I. Who was running right up to the wall here? Damn Russians.
Yes. In this game, imagine if you just had a. Like, these guys are pretty tough. In this game, especially, these guys are fucking gods. Two attacks each, regular. Ooh, fours. Jesus. You need fours to kill them. But, unfortunately, I should have grabbed that with an experienced squad and have them stand there to
yeah
fight, but whatever. All right, so I've got eight guys. Makes you want to have paid the 3 points for the submachine gun. Oh, I actually have a pistol in each. This loader has a pistol. I totally forgot about in those other combats. I've got a pistol in each of my units.
Oh, nice.
So I actually get 9 attacks. The guy has to be alive in order to strike, though, because in that combat you killed every guy.
Yeah.
And that one, you killed every guy. I would have one more attack, but 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Because I had 8 guys, 1 has a pistol.
Yeah. Forgot about that pistol.
This is definitely the list strategy too. Your list strategy was street brawlers or something.
Pretty much.
Yeah. All right. So we're leading threes.
All right. 1, 2.
One and a two.
4, 5, 6.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you killed 6.
Yep.
One. Here's my pistol guy. He'll stay. He's my light machine gun. Everyone. Well, so you don't want the NCO or the pistol guy. I'll keep the light machine gun in my NCO. Everyone else croaks. And I killed 7 of you, so that means I win the combat.
Okay.
And you're entirely destroyed.
Are they all gone?
Yeah, because I win. Ah, I did one more wound than you. And those aren't fanatics. The other guys are fanatics. If you had been a fanatic, we would have done another round of combat with the survivors.
I think I only had like one survivor, though.
Yeah, but if he was a fanatic, he would have stayed, yeah.
That goddamn lieutenant.
Close combat is so brutal. It's all about gotta be defending an obstacle. If you get caught in the street, like my guys did right there, it's a fucking bloodbath. I mean, you get just creamed.
It did. I removed it.
I took it over there, yeah.
Me again. And there we go.
It might have been that pistol, that extra attack that gave me that one to get over the.
I think I'm gonna shoot those guys. Those guys.
Yeah.
Yep. Might as well.
Okay.
So, 3. That'd be 6.
Normally 3. Soft cover 4. Inexperienced 5. And small team now. So 6.
Yeah.
Because I'm down to 2 guys. It didn't matter. 5s or 6s. Didn't matter.
Goddamn. That's you.
Okay, I'm gonna advance this. I could shoot you at point blank. Well, let's see. I don't have to advance because it's not a. You know, it is a. It's not a fixed team, so that means it has 360. So I'll just shoot you.
Fire. And you're on the side now, I think it looks like.
Looks like it, but I'm not point blank. So normally, I just need a 3. I'd have been point blank and I'd have been a 2. So I'm needing a 3. Hit. And your sidearm is a 7. And I've got +2, so I need a 5 to glance, 6 to penetrate.
Didn't penetrate. So just a pin. Alright. I need to mobilize you or something.
I got this. I'm going to use my sniper. I'll just activate them
first. Yep. So it's normally 9, so it'd be a 7 because of the dent man down and good to go. So it takes the pin off.
And then we're just going to shoot into those guys right there.
Okay. Normally 3, sniper scope 2, down a man 3.
5.
Yep. And killing on a 3 up.
Oh, God.
It's a pin.
You can't win with those guys.
Yeah, he's done that this whole game, hasn't he?
Yeah. That's you.
I got one lieutenant left.
That's all I got left, too.
Go over there.
Okay, my last one's with
okay.
My lieutenant that probably won't make it out to the battlefield yet.
Yeah, there's a commissar coming around.
Yep, put the dice pack in the bag.
Yeah, there's a commissar coming around to visit. Have a little chat. A little chatty chat.
Yeah. Came in with that guy.
Alright, turn 5.
That's all you this turn. All right. I was better off picking an aquatic unit.
That was a waste of 35 points.
I just can't, for the life of me, can't. It's like a machine gun. How long did it take me to get that thing out?
Yeah, and that was regular. Well, he basically counts as regular because he gives himself a plus 1. Blue. So I will run my sync. Well, maybe I gotta activate him. They're normally 9. A pin 8, but back to a 9. Come on. That would've sucked. I kinda already measured, so I'll just run to right and next turn I'll be able to get off.
Ugh. Need to kill him.
Probably could have waited on that, but you'd have like a no cover shot right there. So worst case, make you work for it, you know. All right, so they run there.
Damn.
Almost off.
Damn top secret.
I never win this one. It's a miracle that I'm doing so well.
I'm gonna move my tank. All right, here's a pin. So it was a. What did you say, was it 6 last time?
Normally it's a
9.
And so 1 pin, 8. Yeah, regulars are up. That shooting, you know, to really knock that
up. I haven't really need to move.
What are you trying to shoot at?
Your similes.
Well, I got this woods, so you can only, you can't see through 2 inches of it. So you're going to need to turn and kind of plow through it. Which you can, tank tracks, you just can't run. My gun now, because I can't see through 2 inches of woods.
That's right, shooting to begin with. This is the last time I do it. I don't know if I want to use the autocannon or the machine gun.
Well, autocannon, if you get lucky, you're going to be hitting on like 3s because movement, but you're point blank. So if you fire at HE, you get a good roll and you can kill, if you need to kill 3 guys to force a break check. Hmm. If you can do that with a medium machine gun, or you can do it with that. You don't want to fire at armor piercing because you can only kill 2.
Yeah.
So it's either HE shot with the plus 1 penetration, and you need D2, so I would do that.
Yeah, might as well.
I mean, it's a pretty good shot, 3s.
You get 2 dice?
2 dice, needing 3s to hit.
1.
And then it's D2 hits with the HE, so 4, 5, or 6 will give you a second shot.
1.
So it's just the 1 hit, but it's at plus 1, so killing on a 3.
God. There's nothing today.
It's a pin. I failed.
That's kind of the last dish ever, isn't
it? Yeah, I could fail that order check, you know, and be stuck there for. Alright, now I gotta keep those guys over there. I'm gonna fuck it. Let's see. I'm gonna charge you.
Yeah.
I gotta activate. Oh, if I fail this, that'll suck. If I fail this, that'll suck. Alright, so normally I'm at 8, 7, but back to an 8. Come on, Pepe. Lieutenant. 8. Thank you for the lieutenant. If you wouldn't have been there, I would have failed, and then I would have got fucking overran. So I pass. I'm going to run, and I'm going to assault those guys. I think I'm within 6, so you're not going to be able to do any reaction or fire. Too close to react.
Okay.
So.
11 dice? Jesus.
You're sick. I gotta go first though, because you're not defending an obstacle.
Oh, yeah.
So hopefully.
I'll wait.
That's the only advantage. Because I need to inflict some wounds here. If you were regulars, this would be a lost cause. Or veterans, I mean. I got 8 attacks. Actually, I got 9 because I have a pistol. 9 attacks. Go pistol. And I need 3s. Uh oh. It's a lot of 1s.
I'm sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5, yeah, but I was hoping for more than that. So 5 guys go down. We'll just take off random guys. Okay, that's a little better. You got 5, you don't have any special equipment, right?
I don't think so.
If you get all 5, it'll be a draw.
Yeah, they're just a regular. Entire squad is green, yeah.
Oh, they're green?
That's what it says.
Have they taken a casualty yet?
Oh, that was the first one. Yeah, it says inexperienced rifle squad.
Green. Okay, as soon as you take your first casualty for a green squad, roll a dice. On a 1, you take an additional D6 pins. Okay, but it's irrelevant because we're in close combat.
Okay.
And all pins get removed.
Okay.
If you would have rolled a 5 or a 6, you would have become a regular squad.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. I forgot to do that for them. You want to roll it or just skip it?
Yeah, we'll skip it.
Okay.
It has already been done over with.
Because it's when you take your first casualty. So, they took their first casualty in that close combat.
Yeah.
So, it really wouldn't have affected that roll, but it would affect subsequent ones. Here, you took your first casualty in close combat.
No, he got hit in the building.
They did. They lost a guy. Yep. If you would have rolled a 5 or a 6, you would have become a regular, and that would have changed that whole flank.
That's all right.
Or you could have rolled a 1 and took D6 pins and been out of the game as far as the pins. Yeah. Remember that, though, because that's a great little rule, especially when you're talking about close combat and stuff, because it's like, whatever, because I take D6 pins, I'm in close combat, they all get removed anyway. Doesn't affect it. But you could find out you're regular.
Yep.
The good news is you get pinked by like that one shot. It's like, pink, ha, I put a pin on you. Oh, thanks. Now I'm a regular. All right. So, you got your attacks?
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4.
5 would have been a draw. So you killed 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 would have been a draw, then we would have done another combat.
Yep. But my whole squad's wiped out, right?
Yep. Because they're not fanatics. But your army list, you can actually upgrade all your squads to fanatics in this army list.
Yeah, I saw it on there.
But it's 3 points per guy. It's pretty expensive.
I don't know what fanatics.
But you may want to end up doing that with the with like maybe a submachine gun squad or something.
Yeah,
like maybe a 5-man submachine gun squad, and then pay the 15 points to make them fanatic just for that one round of you roll shitty or something.
I roll shitty this whole fucking
thing.
I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
It happens though. It's about time, last time I played you, I beat you.
Yes.
Some do for a loss.
Yes. And you're playing an army that you never played before.
Yeah. I still think it's fun. Win or lose, I still have a blast.
Oh yeah. That's why this campaign is just, it's for fun. I mean, there's no prize. You don't win nothing. So next, I gotta go get Riley.
You just wanna call it? You pretty much won.
You wanna call it?
Yeah, you pretty much won.
We can go to the next turn. Those guys hadn't activated yet, right?
No.
Let's just see what would happen on turn 6. If I pull the first dice, I'm running off. If you pull a first dice, you're gonna obviously shoot me with your tank.
Yeah.
And then I'll have to pass an order check. Because this guy would run to here. I don't think there's much you can do about it, because they had already activated. Nope. Sniper can't see him. Alright, so let's pick these up. You should have. Make sure you got the right amount of dice. I've got
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I got 7, and you've got 4 now.
Yeah, because I got this one.
You got the lieutenant still.
Oh, yeah. So 5.
So we had that right.
I forgot about the little fucking lieutenant.
His order dice. If anything, he's a 35-point order dice.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right. So this would be the start of turn 6. If you get the first dice, I couldn't even, I couldn't do anything to get to where I could shoot the dove. Yeah. So it's all about the next order though. I have one pin on me, and I have a lieutenant who ran down there. So you go ahead and draw. If it's me, I'm running off. If it's you, you got a chance to stop me. It's me, so I run off.
Damn.
All right, because if I would have had to, if you would have shot me again, put it, you could have killed, let's say you didn't kill me, I would have had two pins on me, I would have been a six, plus one for the lieutenant, seven. That's the one.
Yeah, you got it.
Oh, good game.
Oh, yeah, that was fun. God, that was fun.
We'll do it some more. That was some fucking good pictures, though, I'll tell you what. That one turn where the order dice came out for my Singalese. Otherwise, look how fast all these squads are going.
Oh, yeah.
I would have been like,
my whole plan.
Because what would have happened in something like that, even if I ended up winning, would be carrying the plans back.
Yeah.
Now the tank would be like, oh, I got this.
My whole plan was to either light them up with your Singalese, either the machine gun or the tank, just to put pins on them.
Yeah.
And then I was just going to swarm the whole courtyard.
That's what I was like. That's why I kind of screened it. It's like, okay, that squad will kill them. That squad will kill them. If the Singalese pass, I'll run that way. And it's like, because I still have this squad here. I was like, and then that's what's left of that squad was this squad. I'm like, they'll run by, they'll block off the road. That was kind of, but I was like, it'd be much more hairier. Passing a lot more checks. Because then after that, you would have won those mini though. You would have won those because this one we would have wheeled. Yeah, it's close.
Mm. Look, that was 12 last.
Shit was dying fast. we're like, okay, need sevens. Nobody died. Okay, need sixes. Nobody died. Okay, kill everybody. It's like,
goddamn Russians. Drinking too much vodka. It's all right.
Very fun. Very fun.